Welcome to Modular Classroom. Today in this video, we will see about a tool called AHA Slides. So what it is? It is one of the great tools to increase the effectiveness of online meetings and trainings, and it allows actively interact with the audience. So with AHA Slides, you can able to create full interactive presentations with polls. That is, you can add polls, live chats, and you can engage the question and answer session. You can add fun quizzes and games to your presentation. That is, it is one of the audience engagement platform for classes, online meetings and events. And also can be said, it is the only interactive presentation software in the market today that allows you to fully customize your presentation with many beautiful colors and themes, and most important is it is all for free. And if you already view our video in our channel posted related to Mentimeter, then you can able to see if you are using the basic plan, it has been limited only 2 questions per presentation and only fewer question type and no customization ability in your basic plan. But in AHA Slides, on the other hand, it is very easy because you can add more features mainly for free. And there are no limit on the question that you can ask in the presentation. You can have as many polls and quizzes, and it is unlimited. And another important feature is it requires no credit card to sign up. And free users have unlimited questions, full access to all slide types, and it is cheaper than compared to Mentimeter and other tools also. And here you can invite your audience to join through access code or by giving a customizable link or by allowing them to scan a QR code. Now we will enter into the demo by seeing how to use that AHA Slides. Go to Google and type AHA Slides here. See, this is the first link. It will take you to the ahaslides.com. As the name says here, it is an interactive presentation software for your meetings. Just click on this link. If you are not logged in yet, here you can able to see a message, get started. As I have already logged in with my Gmail account, it says you can start with your presentation. As you can see, here is the first, are you a participant? Here it allows you to write the code and you have to join. If you are a participant, you can go to ahaslides.com and you can enter the code that has been given by your trainer or your teacher, and you can able to click this join button. But if you are going to organize this AHA Slides presentation, now you can click your presentation's link so that you can able to create a new presentation. See, as you can see, this is by default you will have a sample team meeting, sample lesson 2 presentation with the access code. Now you can also, you're going to start with by clicking this new button, you're going to create a new presentation. I'm giving the name demo. And say this is the name of the presentation, and I'm clicking create presentation. Okay, now this is a window that is being directed towards me after I'm giving the name of this presentation as demo. And as you can see, as in the Mentimeter, you have the option called new slide button. And here are the question types, multiple choice, image choice, open-ended, word cloud, scales, question answer like this. These types, you can able to ask the questions to the audience. See, whenever you click on this question, you can able to on this side, choose a slide type. To begin, in this window you can able to see that a particular question type, how it appears. See, if you ask a multiple question, this is the way the question appears, and if it is an image, it will appear like this, and if it is a word cloud, it appears like this. This is a question type, and the second thing is you can connect a quiz game, so this is the way the quiz question appears, and the contents like this, it will appear. So first I'm going to ask with a question type, I'm clicking this multiple choice. It is being loaded. The multiple choice question. This is a question what I'm going to type over here. As you can see, automatically this particular code will be generated. If I need this code to be reframed, I can also able to edit this code by clicking on this pencil icon. If I need, I can able to edit. So here I'm going to type the question. For example, easiest question, I'm just giving X and RAM. So my question options are read access memory, random access memory, and random alert memory. I can choose anything. And here, and if you can see here, these are the other settings that can be set apply for this question. Question, you can hide the results, show results and percentage for this question. Time limit, if you need, you can include anything. You can set a particular option. And see, you can here the next important in our slides is here you can able to choose the background. Whatever background you need, you can choose. I can able to change the color, and I can able to include any particular option like this. I can change the background like this, and otherwise I also can add a background image. If I need, I can add. Otherwise, I can leave with this customized any color. I can leave it. And after I can able to change my visibility, background visibility. I can also able to touch up. If I need, I can do it. Otherwise, I can also move to the next option of my audio. But this audio feature is only available if my account has been upgraded. So the first question I have added, and I'm going to the second slide. I'm clicking insert, and I'm choosing word cloud. I'm asking favorite online tools. Three entries can be allowed by the participants. And after that, I can also add a background for this question. I can give this background as second slide. I can change, I can able to change my background. And after my questions have been inserted, and I can able to ask the other questions to be included. For example, if I am clicking this quiz, if I change this particular one as a quiz, I can able to include the leaderboard so that who will be the topper of this quiz game, I can able to find out. This leaderboard displays the particular person's answer, who is going to win in that particular quiz game. So after designing like this, and after moving through on the various different types of settings that has been available in the Zaga slides, now I can move on to this share. Before I am presenting, I have to share this particular code to my participants or my students. So I'm clicking the share button so that I can able to get this particular code, or I can give this QR code to my participants. This is the second step. So you can able to copy this link and you can send to the participants. So after sending, now you can able to click this present button, and it will be asked a question like you have not said the correct answer. So if you want, you can give, or you can set this particular question as the correct answer. So I'm clicking this as a correct answer, and now I'm presenting. So now I can wait for some more minutes so that the participant can join. So that they can able to attend this particular interactive presentation. We will wait for 2 minutes so that the participants can able to join by this link. So we can, as you can see, there are 2 persons has been joined with the name Rani and Priya. Now I'm clicking start the quiz. So this is the first question. The answer should be made by them as, say, everyone has two of them have answered this question as correct. Now I am moving to the second question. They can give a word. get the three of the answers. So Mentimeter, Zoom and Meet, they have given them as a favorite online tool. Another person has given Socrative, Aha tool. So we have got the Discord cloud in this format of the answers. So six answers we have received. If you see in the previous slide, we have two votes. And finally, the result is being loaded. How many of students have gained how many points? So as you can see, two players. Priya is the winner here. Since she has received 84 points, Priya is the winner. So you can able to see how the winner is being celebrated here. With the crackles, with the burning lights, they have been encouraged. The participants have been encouraged with this leaderboard so that you can able to see Priya has won this quiz by getting 84 points. So thank you, Priya, for participating. Thank you. Now I can either close this button or I can choose the menu and I can go to stop presenting so that this quiz can be stopped. At the same time, if I get this participant view, I can able to view in the screen how the participants can join with the mobile. See, like this, they can able to join. They can access with the mobile like this. See, Priya has 84 points. She is a winner and she got the bumpered color crayons that is being poured on her. So this is way the August lines can be used to encourage or engage the audience with this interactive presentation by conducting quizzes, polls, asking question and answers, everything. So thank you for watching. Stay tuned.